Hi beautiful crafty people, it's Asia Marke here for Lindy's Gang, and in this project I'm using two squirts and showing you how with two squirts you can get a whole bunch of beautiful colors. This is my art journal page, even though I'm not working in art journal, but I'm using watercolor paper. However, I'm gonna treat the paper beforehand with a gesso. This is white gesso from Finavar, and I'm applying it with an old card. I prefer that to brush application because first of all it's much quicker, and then also I don't have the traces of bristles on the paper. So after the application, of course, I let it to dry. And then I'm gonna be adding some stenciling. This time I'm using a stencil from Maremi Small Art, Marta Łapkowska. And I'm gonna be doing vertical lines on the paper. And for that I'll use Ricoh Design Fine Grain Structure Paste, which is a fine grain, basically a paste, which goes very well with tiny designs on the stencil. Everything has dry up, so this time I'm gonna wet it back again with a mini mister, and I'm gonna add some colors. I'm starting with Canadian Bacon Blush. It's a squirt, beautiful squirt. So basically what squirts are, if you don't know, they are paints similar to Starbursts, I would say, because they all have shine to them. But what is different is that they are coming with the bottle which has a cap which you can unscrew, and they are not sprays. The reason for that is that they are simply less fluidy, so they are more heavy bodied, not that much also, they are not acrylics, far from that, but they have this different texture which gives you different opportunities to work with, and gives you a different effect. And look at that. This is just one squirt. It's beautiful. It's this pink with golden effects, really, truly beautiful. And I love squirts for that because the colors they gave, they are really unique. The next color, the next squirt is Polite People Purple. Yeah, of course you can just unscrew the cap and add to the paper like I'm doing, the same way. Or you can use the brush, of course, and you can add to the paper with a brush. I decided to do it like that, just be careful, because well, when you unscrew the bottle, there is quite a lot of the squirt coming out, and maybe you won't need that much, so just be careful with that. And I am making them flow on the paper, again with my mini mister. The reason for using mini mister is simple. Mini mister is more precise. It's easier to control. The spray is not as wide as when you would use a bigger bottle, bigger spray bottle. And of course I'm drying the next layer, and I've decided that I don't have enough of the beautiful pink and golden squirt, so I'm adding a little bit more in the places I needed. This project is a little unique for me because there is not that much negative, white negative space. Almost the whole paper is taken by the squirts, but really they are so beautiful that I just decided to do it a little bit differently this time. So squirts are the newest product from Lindy's Gang, even though they've been on the market for a few months already. They are really graceful to work with, really beautiful. And as other sprays of Lindy's, they are sent in a form of the powder. So if you buy them, you get them in a form of the powder. Then you just have to heat up a little water, in preference the water which is demineralized. And then fill up the bottle, and you can, after 10-20 minutes, you can start using them. That is done just because to save the costs of postage, so you pay less. Beforehand you've seen me doing some stamping. I've done stamping with Viva Las Vegas stamp and wilted violet on distress oxides. Now I'm gonna be doing some embossing, And for that, I'm using All and Create Stamp and Clear It Embossed Pad from Rangers. And I'm gonna be also using a beautiful Aurora Amethyst two-toned embossing powder from Lindy's. Two-toned means that the same embossing powder will look differently on the darker surface to how it look on the white surface, basically. I need to add some more contrast. For that, I'm gonna be using Black Jet Archival ink and again stamp from All and Create to just get these black accents, which I love very much. And the next step will be to add some embellishments. I started with adding a thread on the background. I am also using Maremi Small Art Art Technique paper elements and a stamp which I designed for AB Studio. I cut it out some of the pieces of the stamp and they're gonna be serving me as a kind of leaves. And firstly, I'm gonna arrange everything on the page, and when I'm happy with the arrangement, I'm gonna adhere everything with a tacky glue to the surface. Well, not actually everything, because some of the flowers and leaves I'll adhere with a 3D foam tape, so like that I'll get the difference of levels on the page. I am also adding some kind of a black tweak to the page. This time I'm gonna be using a 3D matte gel because it has a better hold on it, and because the twig is so twisted and uneven, I can adhere it only in a few spots only, and thanks to 3D matte gel I will have this certainty that it will hold. So there was something missing from my video until now, and definitely it was a splatter. And for that I'm using again a blazing black, which I love for my splatter purposes, and I'm splattering the paint all over the page, but also to get a little bit more of the contrast I am gonna apply it onto the edges of the paper, and for that I will use a flat brush and just dip the brush in the paint and just kind of clean it on the edges, just the way I'm doing right now. I'm also adding a tiny bit of heavy white gesso with a tiny palette knife, and because the palette knife is tiny and because I'm doing it with palette knife simply, The gesso kind of stays on the relief which I achieved with the stenciling. And the reason for me in doing so is just to again add some bit of the contrast, because the flowers, my focal point, are very similar in color, on the purple ones anyway, to the background, and I want to separate them from the background a little. And I'm finishing with a splatter I'm doing with a sidewalk chalk and some stickers, again from Maremi Small Art. And because the stickers are quite thin, I'm gluing them on the cardboard paper, then I'm cutting it out, also distressing a little bit the edges, or maybe not distressing, but adding a black archival ink to the edges after cutting it out, and then placing it onto the paper with a 3D foam tape, and also adding a little bit more of darkness with the distress ink to the edges of the paper. As I mentioned, this is very unusual page for me, not a lot of negative space, also a lot of flowers. I don't usually work too much with flowers, but then here it is. And look at this beautiful, beautiful shine, beautiful colors I got with using only two squirts. Of course, I use also embossing powder and black and white, but that's it. Thank you so much for being here with me and with Lindis. And well, I hope to see you soon. Wish you a beautiful, beautiful day. Bye!